Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Can't sing anymore because it'll be copyrighted. Hey guys, Gomirath here. Today I'm going to be bringing you a guide to all the pets in the Eastern Kingdoms. Now, the Eastern Kingdoms has a heck of a lot more pets than Kalimdor. Like, or not necessarily pets, but zones. There's just so many more. I think it's because Blizzard likes the Alliance better. And so they focused and made all these awesome zones. And then the Horde, they're like, oh yeah, we'll just make the Barons and we're going to make it enormous. But anyway, enough of my political commentary. Let's get to the first area, which is up here in the Eversong Woods and includes everything in Silvermoon. So Silvermoon has the Guild Vendor, just like I think every major city does. It's over there. And whatever guild that you're in, you know, there's could be some pretty cool guild pets. Now, if you look under here, under guild, there are several pets that you can get from the guild. There's the Dark, Phoenix Hatchling, Little Terragosa. I don't think the River Calf's actually from the guild. Yeah, I'm not sure why he's showing up. And then the Deathwatch Hatchling. I think those are the three right there. Oh, also the Armadillo Pup. But I haven't done anything with my Armadillo Pup. Maybe I'll add him to my leveling queue. Yeah, here's what we'll do. Okay, we'll level you up. And then you can get these Guild Heralds. But those are for Alliance dogs, so I'll never own those. I'm not political, guys. Don't worry. I don't favor the Horde over those filthy dogs, the Alliance. So don't even worry about that for a second. So we're going to start up here. Now, in this zone, there's actually a couple pets, and especially for a starting zone, that are really fantastic. So right here, this vendor, Jelani, she has three really good pets. She's got the Red Dragonhawk, Golden Dragonhawk Hatchling, and Silver Dragonhawk Hatchling. Now, let's just type in Dragonhawk. Okay, so these Dragonhawks, they have several different breeds, but for the Golden Dragonhawk Hatchling, as always, I'll recommend the pure breed over any balance breed, just because there's so many less stats in a balance breed. For the Red Dragonhawk Hatchling, though, I would recommend Power Speed breed. I almost always prioritize power and speed over just pure speed. The pure speed breed does have 325, which is decent for dragon type, just because dragons are really slow. And you're not going to see a lot of pets that have 325 speed, but also have 276 attack. So, you know, I'm going to throw that speed into my leveling queue. Yeah, look at this. Me throwing leveling guys in here all the time. And then this Blue Dragonhawk here, I would recommend the Power Speed breed again. I have the HH breed, but I mean, I guess I could buy pets until I get the Power Speed breed from her. But I already have one. These guys all have the same moveset. So, but they're dragons that you can pick up really cheap. Like, how much are these? Yeah, 40 silver apiece. So if you're a new player, these are fantastic pets to get. Even though they're just green quality when you first learn them, they'll still serve you well versus a lot of different guys. The other pet I want to talk about here, Ruby Sapling. Now, the Ruby Sapling is, I think, one of the lowest level elemental pets that you can snag in the game. You can snag him here. This is a level 1 through 3 pet zone. So you can pick up these guys, and then you'll have a leveling pet that's strong versus mechanical types. And you really don't run into a lot of them in Tamers, especially as Horde. As Alliance, I'm not sure what Tamer, the first one that you go against that has a mechanical pet. But definitely one, if you're going to hunt for a rare version, I would hunt for a rare version of one of these guys. Just because if you're starting out, it's nice to have a rare elemental that can do some serious damage to machines. So that wraps up Silvermoon City. And is this Eversong Woods? Is that where I'm at right now? Yeah, Eversong Woods. And now we're going to head down to the Ghostlands. All right, we are now in... I just said this name, the Ghostlands. Okay, so we are now in the Ghostlands, and there is a tier 1 pet here that is fantastic. He is really, really powerful in PvP, and definitely a pet that you want to pick up. This is the HH Spirit Crab. Now, this guy has a very, very tanky 1,887 health as an undead, and he's got a ton of moves that they're aqua-type moves. He's got two aqua-type moves, two beast-type moves, and amplify magic. So one thing that's cool is that this is a pet. He's an undead who can actually counter critters. Now, most undeads just absolutely get ripped apart by critters, but because of his shell shield and snap combo, he really can just totally negate most critter damage. This is a pet you want to pick up. He's one of the best pets in the game, and they're all over the coast here. And this, like I said, is in the Ghostlands. Also, by the way, have you noticed that there's like a zone right here that you can't get to? Maybe it's Stratholme. I don't know. But it's on the map, but there's nothing there. It's X-Files thing. Okay, so get back to the pets. And you can also get the voodoo figurine from archaeology. But once again, this is a pet that I've literally never used. So, I mean, you can come here and get undead pets just because they're kind of cooler than other pets. But then again, just nothing special. So, yeah, I'd skip Eastern Plaguelands. Alright guys, we are now over in the Western Plaguelands. And there is actually a really powerful pet to pick up here. This is another pet that's really strong in PvP. Don't really use him in PvE ever, but definitely somebody who you want to snag. Now, I'm talking about the Blighthawk, okay? The Blighthawk, at one time, I think he was the hardest hitting Ghostly Bite user in the game. That was before Warlords of Draenor and the Ghostly Pup came out. But the Blighthawks, they're found here in this area. Pull up my map real quick. Yeah, just right over here near this town. So just left of the Writhing Haunt. And they're fantastic. So they're really popular in clone dance teams where you throw out Cyclone and then you switch into a pet that has Rain Dance. And that was like the meta a while ago where that's all people were using, was they'd throw out Cyclone from this guy because he's got a really high attack at 305. Let's see. CYC. Cyclone. Okay. So, you know, there's a couple other pets that have stronger Cyclones than this guy, but because he was undead, he was also really good against humans, and the racial is kind of broken. So, he was really, really popular. I'd recommend a power speed breed and a health power breed. I have not picked up a health power breed, and it's not a pet that I'm really grinding for, but definitely if you want to pick up a really cool looking undead pet, you know, this guy, he's a fantastic choice. And he's still really good in PvP, but the meta is not quite so undead heavy as it used to be. So for Western Plaguelands, definitely snag yourself a Blighthawk. Alright guys, we're making our way here into the Trisfall Glades, and I want to talk about the one pet that I would pick up here. Now, this pet, you actually had to use to be a warlock to be able to see him. You'd go outside of Undercity, and they used to have this spell that was like see invisible or something, or to detect invisibility. And you put it on yourself, and you'd be able to see all these little pets around. Now, the loss of Lordaeron, he's nothing to write home about. Like, he's not amazing. But he can come in a health breed, and it actually has a decent amount of health, and he's pretty good against flying type pets, honestly. He's got Arcane Explosion, and okay, I guess that's the only magic type of pet that he has. But he has Curse of Doom, which is a really strong move, you know, 600 damage, and Absorb. So he's a really tanky undead pet, kind of cool. I would definitely add him to your collection, but he's not a game-breaking pet. So don't worry too bad if you don't have him. You can pick them up when you're on your safari quest. So that basically does it for Trisfall Glades. All right, I'm making my way over here to the Hillsbrad foothills. And there's a couple pets in this zone that are definitely worth snagging. So, oh, by the way, the reason I didn't cover Silver Pine Forest is it's got all the same pets as Eastern Plagueland. So, yeah, nothing great. But here in Hillsbrad Foothills, just need my map to stay here. They have these lofty Librams, which are kind of a cool pet. Like, I just like pets that are different than everything else that you see. And there's just a ton of critters, a ton of beast types, and a ton of flying types in the world, as well as aqua types. So these rarer pets are just kind of cool. And the lofty Librum does look cool. Now, he's just found all around here, all around the old Dalaran portal. By the way, you used to die when you got ported here. They fixed it. During, I think it was Pandaria. Yeah, it was during Pandaria that you got the tome to learn that. And anyway, he would send me here all the time and try to kill me. And he did many, many times. But he learned that from me. So the other pet to pick up here in this area is the Infected Bear Club. Okay. Now, what makes the Bear Club really strong is undeads, for the longest time, they ruled the PvP meta, where it's like that's all anybody played was just teams of undeads. And he had Disease Bite, pardon me, as well as Hibernate and Maul. And you could switch out that for Bash. And a stun in PvP is pretty powerful. And so he hit really hard. And, oh, I'm about to fly into the ruins of Gilneas. That's the Worgen starting area, right? I think it is. Okay, sorry. Got a little off course there, talking about that infected bear cub. But the bear cub, he can be used pretty effectively in some PvP teams, especially if you got a bleed team. Like, you can get an undead bleed team and then throw in this guy with Maul and get some nice success. But yeah, these infected bear cubs are found over here by this mine next to all these infected bears. By the way, since they updated the character model, these bears like make me kind of sick looking at all the, you know, spider eggs on their back. Ugh, it's just gross. So let's see. Infected bear club, yeah. Right over there. Oh, man, that's so gross. I do not like looking at those. So that wraps it up for Hillsbred Foothills. Also, there is the fossilized hatchling, who's a really popular, used to be incredibly popular when the only thing you saw in the meta was just undead AoE. And since he had Bone Storm and Ancient Blessing, like, he was all anybody used. And he got so annoying. Ugh. I'm grateful that the meta has shifted. So that sums up Hillsbred for you.
All right, we are over here in the Arathi Highlands, and I'm going to talk about these little tiny twisters. Now, the tiny twister is actually kind of a cool pet. He is an elemental pet that is strong versus aquatics. Now, that's kind of a dicey role to play, because aquatics are the anti-elemental, and they take bonus damage from aquatics. But there are some fights, especially up in the Broken Isles, where you have to beat a tamer with entirely one type of pet. And to have an elemental pet that's strong versus aquatics is kind of cool to have. Now, I would recommend picking up the health power breed or the health speed breed. You know, the power balance breed isn't terrible. It's got the highest attack out of any of them at 289. Or, no, what is it? Yeah, 289 attack. Except health power also is 289. You know what? Just stick with the health power breed. The other pet in this zone that shows up is the Clockwork Gnome. He's found here through archaeology. He's actually pretty rare. It took me a long time to get mine. They also sell in the auction house for like 20,000 gold, depending on the server you're at. But while you're here in Arathi Highlands, I would definitely pick up a tiny twister. That's what I was trying to click there. All right, that'll do it for Arathi Highlands.
All right, guys, we are now over in the Hinterlands, and there is a prize pet in this zone, okay? And that pet is the Jade Oozling. Now, the Jade Oozling comes in four breeds: Power Power, HH, Health Speed, and a Balance Balance, okay? As always, ignore Balance Balance. Now, I wanted to go for the Power Power breed just because he has already 1481 health, which is slightly above average, but just a ton of power, and so it makes this guy just absolutely destroy flying types. Like, Expunge can hit up to 700 damage. So he's got three really, really strong moves versus flying types, as well as an undead type attack. So if you use him in PvP, he can do decent damage against humanoids, as well as critters or aqua types. Or no, excuse me. Oh, that's strong versus undead, and then that's strong versus elemental. So he's just a really well-rounded pet. They're only found in this cave right here. right by the Shimmering Rock. No, Skull Rock. Just because I've got this add-on up, it makes me kind of hard to find everything. So, yeah, these Jade Ooslings right here, I'd recommend picking up a Power breed and an HH breed. But the Power breed is definitely the one that you want to search for. And then everything else in this zone is a garbage.
All right, we've made our way down to the wetlands. And there's a pet who's decent. He's kind of cool. He's unique. He's the tiny bog beast. He's got a pretty cool character model. And he's an elemental type that's got two humanoid moves, and then he's got two beast-type attacks as well, as long with two elemental attacks. So he's a really well-rounded pet. Now, Lash is a move that benefits greatly from going first, and his health speed breed is actually not that fast. It's only 289, which is, you know, what is that, 29 points above, so 30 points above average speed. So, I mean, you could always... Here's the thing, is that you can't use Leap in conjunction with Lash. So, he's not phenomenal by any means, but he's kind of cool, and he's good in a few unique situations. Where if you're going up against critter-type pets, and you need elementals with beast-type damage. There's another two pets that drop in here. The Crimson Whelpling and the Dark Whelp. And they're world drops, and they're less than a 1% drop. There's dragons over here that you can kill, and same with over there. But those are... If you're into farming, you can farm for those. I am not. I don't like killing low-level mobs over and over and over again thousands of times just to get a vanity pet. Because neither of these guys are all that good. Like the Dark Whelp, he's a power speed breed with 240 speed. Okay? Baseline speed for most pets, like, look at this. Okay, he's 211. That's not a good example. He's 244. Man. Well, apparently he's not that slow. I mean, he's 240. But most other pets, yeah, you're looking at a 260 base speed. 260 base speed, 260 base attack. So, I wouldn't really spend my time worrying about anything other than just snagging a little tiny bog beast. And I pick up the health power breed for the bog beast, or one of each. There's only three breeds, so it's pretty easy to get the one you want. Alright, we are now making our way into the Twilight Highlands. Now, this is actually a really cool zone. They've got some really cool pets here. So, one of them you have to have an alliance character to get, and that is the Wild Hammer Griffin Hatchling. Now, these are really cool looking pets. They look just like the ones that you used to be able to buy off the auction house for the young Griffinling and then the young Wyvern, but they don't fly along with you when you're on your mount. But they're still really cool. So I picked up a power breed and then a speed breed. Don't use them very often. I mean, he's good in a couple particular fights, but yeah, it's just cool to have a pet that looks like a small griffin. And those are found right up here. Let's see. Right at the very top of the map where my cursor is at. And you have to, once again, you have to be alliance to be able to pick him up. So, yeah, that's the first one that I would grab. If you have an alliance alt, I got two free faction. Well, I got faction changes for free a long time ago when my server was changing. It was like getting moved into a different battle group. And so I changed over to the two characters I played the least, my shaman and my hunter. And now I never play them because they're alliance. But I know I should be bipartisan, so to all the Alliance players who are watching my video, I do understand that there's a place in this world for you. I just wish you wouldn't kill me all the time while I'm trying to do pet battles. The other pet that I would pick up here is the Twilight Fiend. Now, the Twilight Fiend is really cool, okay? So he's a magic-type pet that rolls all these different kinds of abilities. So he's got two undead moves, he's got two beast moves, he has one aquatic move, and then he has one magic move. So he's kind of all over the place. He can be really useful in certain situations, but yeah, he's just really cool. Also, he looks terrifying. And these guys are all over the place. So the other pets in this zone, you know, the Twilight Spider, he's decent. but he's just like almost every spider in the game up until the Broken Isles had the exact same moveset. So, I mean, you can pick him up. He's nothing special. So I would pick up from this zone Wild Hammer, Griffin Hatchling, and you have to be on an Alliance character, and the Twilight Fiendling. And the Fiendling? That's a hard word to say. I'd get a power breed. Because here's the thing. Stacking health on a magic type kind of is counterproductive of their racial. Because their passive is magic pets cannot be dealt more than 35% of their maximum health. So, I mean, even having a little squishy magic pet, your racial still can counter some other pets very nicely. Alright, we are over here in Loch Modan, and there are two pets I would snag. Now, these are not pets that are particularly fantastic, at least the little black ram isn't, but he's cool, and he's a little ram. Like, he looks like a goat, you know? And I think that's actually pretty awesome. I like it. He also has Soothe, which is a decent move. But then he's just got all critter type moves. And it's kind of interesting to have a beast type pet that has the vast majority of his moves can all be critter pet or critter type attacks. And I'd pick up the power balance breed. I actually grinded for a power balance breed on this guy. Like, went through probably 15 or 20 of these little rams, and they were all balance. So yeah, that was annoying. But he's not a game breaking pet, but he's kind of cool. I like him. I kind of think of RP whenever I've got him. Like, if I was ever to roll a dwarf, I would have the ram just follow me around. Okay, the other pet in the zone that is actually very, very solid, he's got a good breed, and he hits really hard, is the Snow Cub, okay? And he only comes in three breeds, and I would pick up a power balance breed, a power breed and a power speed breed. Now, this guy has actually a really high amount of attack, 325. I think that's standard for power, but he's also got a decent... Actually, he's got baseline speed and health in the other slots. But it's also cool. I mean, there's a ton of cub pets in the game. On my monk, I've got like this whole section of my toolbar. It's just all different cub pets. And depending on whatever zone I'm in, I'll summon a pet that, or a cub that looks like it could fit in. So if I'm in the Barrens, I'm using a cheetah. Or if I'm in, you know, some snowy area, I've got my snow cub following me. There's actually just a ton of different cub pets out there. So anyway, that sums it up for Loch Modan. And now I wanted to talk really briefly about the area outside of Ironforge, which is known as Dunmoreau. Okay, so there is a pet that is fantastic, and that is the Fluxfire Feline. Now, in order to get the Fluxfire Feline, the very easiest way to pick it up is to be a gnome and to create a gnome, and it's just in the gnome starting area. And these pets used to be really, really, really popular in PvP because they would use Supercharge and either Flux or Pounce. So they could hit really, really hard or like do a Prowl and Pounce combo. And since they're mechanical, it's pretty similar to the Undead Racial in that, you know, you could die and then still have another turn. So I would snag these two pets. I use them in a lot of leveling strategies for lower level fights because these are mechanical pets that are strong versus both critters and beast type pets. And there's only a handful of pets that are strong versus critters and beast types. Yeah. So, and I have a good chunk of them. There's a couple that I'm missing. You know, I need to pick this guy up. My little brother's got one of these. I might steal him from him. He would never notice. No, because stealing's wrong. That's unethical. I would never do that. All right, so that wraps up Dunmoreau. All right, we have made our way over into the Red Ridge Mountains, and I want to talk briefly about the fledgling buzzards. Sometimes my words get all mixed in my mouth. So the fledgling buzzard is the same. Do I have the health? Which are the ones that I have? Buzzard. Yeah, I do not have a health balance breed, but I don't really want the health balance breed.
So these guys have almost the exact same moveset. I think they do have the same moveset as the dragon. Yeah, the dragon won't hatch them. Yeah, okay. So these guys have the same movement set and same stats as the Dragonbone Hatchling, which is a really solid pet. So if you want a really good flying pet to pick up at this level, these guys are great. I would recommend getting the Health Power breed and the HH breed, because they're really, really tanky. I mean, the Health Power breed of these guys has 1600 health, 1627. I think it's the same for the Buzzard pet. Yeah, let's see, health power. Yep, 1627. They're exactly the same stat-wise. So these guys are actually really, really solid, especially when you're low level, if you want a really good flying pet. And having liftoff, which hits way hard, is fantastic. So as far as Red Ridge Mountain goes, I think that's the only pet here that's worth looking at. You know, they've got the Mountain Cottontail, but he can be caught, like, all over the world. Well, he can be caught up in High Mountain, and I would rather catch him at a higher level than a lower level. So, I mean, if you want a hare, they're not really useful outside of PvP, and they need to be the SS breed to be really useful. So, yeah, pardon me, it's early in the morning. I'd pick up the Buzzard, and that's about it from Red Ridge Mountains. Alright, we are now in Elwynn Forest, the Alliance capital of the world, and there's actually two pets here that I would snag if I were you. So the first of those pets being the Black Lamb. Now, they recently updated the character model of these lambs, and they look awesome. They're just like so fuzzy. And let's see, is there any around here? No. And they're also kind of useful in a few unique circumstances. There's one of the tamers in the Broken Isles. He's this giant elemental pet. Oh man, I really need to make these videos later in the day, because right now it's like 8 in the morning, and I know that's not early to some people, but to other people it's the crack of dawn. So this guy is really useful versus a few different tamers, and he's just incredibly adorable. Like, look at him, see him eating that grass. It's so nice. And then the other pet that I would snag here is all these pets that you can buy from the vendors. Now, you need to be Alliance to be able to buy all these vendors here, all these vendor pets, but yeah. And they're not like amazing or anything, especially compared to how the Horde have access to all the dragons, but not bad either. So yeah, I pick up those cat pets because you can just buy them all really cheap. And one of them already comes in a power breed right off the bat. So pick up yourself a little Black Lamb and then go buy all those cat pets. And you can just create a human alt, because Northshire is right there. So you can even just, like, if you don't have any gold on the server as Alliance, just do, you know, like 10 minutes of questing and then go buy them all. Because 40 silver a piece, you know, that adds up to be like 3 gold. So, and that'll do it for Elwynn Forest. Alright, we are now heading into Westfall. And in Westfall, there is an awesome pet here. Now, it's not often that you find like really fantastic pets in low-level zones, but these tiny harvesters are great. Now, I've been searching for a power breed for a bazillion years and have not been lucky enough to snag one. So that's the breed that I really want of the tiny harvester. I already have an HH breed, an SS breed. When I was playing on my brother's account, I was just doing a little bit of pet battling, and the very first tiny harvester I engaged was a rare quality power breed. And I was like, of course, on somebody who literally never ever uses pet battles, you know, he would get that lucky. So he's got the power breed. But that's the pet that I would pick up here. Short grab, he does not have anything fantastic. Yeah, so I would just go for a tiny harvester and search for a power breed. I think I'm going to do that for a little bit before I go to the next zone. All right, we are in Duskwood now. I spent the last probably 20 minutes or 15 minutes trying to find a power breed of the tiny harvester and just killing all the ones that weren't the right breed, and was unsuccessful. The only thing I found that was close was a power balance.
but another day I will go back and continue the search. So, we're in Duskwood now. And in Duskwood, there are actually some super cool pets. I think these are all just the spiderlings. Because in order to get the widow spiderling, I think you have to be... Yeah, it's got to be during the nighttime. Okay? And what's cool about the widow spiderling is she has a power breed. And out of the spiders, there's not a lot of them that have power breeds. So I would recommend picking one up. Also, they've got a really cool character model. I mean, look at that. It is just a... It's the same as these giant black widows here. These guys. But the pet version of it. Oh, sorry. My camera's working out all over the place. But that's what they look like. So they're just really cool looking. And I think that's the only pet that I'd pick up here. Yep, that's the only pet that I would pick up in Duskwood. Alright, right now I'm in the Badlands, which, holy cow, this area has sure changed since the last time I quested here. It was probably Deathwing. Yeah, I don't think I've quested here since Burning Crusade. Or maybe Wrath. No, I think it's Burning Crusade was the last time I quested here. So, the Gold Beetle. Now, this is a pet that I'd never used before, but the other day I just got wrecked by one, and he's got a decent amount of speed. You know, for an SS breed, 309 is not that great. Like, that is the same, I think, as the Mechanical Pandaren Dragonling, which is a pretty slow SS breed. But the guy was running Swarm, Flank, and Hiss. Or maybe he was running Survival. I can't remember what his second column was here. But he just surprised me and did a ton of damage and really messed up my favorite PvP team. So I've picked him up. I haven't used him yet, but I would snag him just because I'm a fairly experienced pet battler, and to be, you know, taken by so surprised there and to be just destroyed by a beetle really, I mean, just really took me aback. So I would pick him up. Then as far as the Burning Steps go, it's basically all the same pets that I mentioned before. The Lava Crab, already talked about him. Now, when I was in the Hillsbred Foothills, I did not mention that the Fossilized Hatchling, he comes from Archaeology. I just talked about how much I disliked that pet when he was all anybody was using. So, Tiny Flameling? Is this from a quest? Yeah, quest. Okay. Well, there's a pet that I need to get from a quest here, which I did not know about. Maybe I'm gonna... Should I do that quest chain right now? Yeah, I think I'm going to. Alright, I'm here in the Blasted Lands right now, and I wanted to give you guys a little tip. So, when I was going for my Safari achievement, I had a really hard time finding... I think it's the Scorpidling, or the Scorpid. I'm not sure which of these guys it was. I think it's just the Scorpidling, because this is the only place he is. Yep, this guy right here. And it took me a really long time to get him. And I could see that, hey, he spawns over here. But he was just never there. And then I went on Reddit and was looking around. And then I saw the tip to talk to this lady here. And show me what the land was before the Burning Legion came in. And now I am in old Blasted Lands. So, like... You know, Khadgar is not waiting at the Dark Portal anymore because I've got this time-traveling buff. And, you know, there's not super high-level elites all around here. They're all level 55 or something. So that's what I had to do in order to find the Scorpidling, and then I was able to find him. Now, he's not a great pet. You just need to pick him up for your achievement for the Zookeeper. The other pets in the zone are garbage, but that's how you find the Scorpidling. Is you talk to that lady, whatever her name was, just at the entrance, and then you'll be able to find the Scorpidling. Alright, we are now in Deadwind Pass, and I'm going to show you the two pets that are here. Now, one of them spawns at all times of the day, and the other one only spawns between, like, midnight and 6 a.m. server time. I think. It actually took me a really long time to get it. I had an alt parked down in one of these cellars who could stealth, because there's a lot of PvP that happens on this server here. And anyway, a lot of the time I don't want to do anything with PvP because I'm not that geared. And so what I did was I just parked an alt down here in order to get the Restless Shadeling. He was the last one that I needed on this continent. And then the Arcane Eye. Now what's cool about the Arcane Eye is he has Mana Surge. And there's not a ton of pets in the game. Oh. Sorry, I'm getting attacked. That have Mana Surge. Okay. Let's see. I mean, it's a fair amount. The Nexus Whelpling, he's my favorite pet that has Mana Surge, because he's got Arcane Storm and Mana Surge, and so does the Stormborn Whelpling. But these other pets here have Mana Surge. And Mana Surge, when Arcane Winds are active, does so much damage. And anyway, you can use them. Like, there's a particular fight in the Celestial Tournament that it's really useful to have either the Arcane Eye or the Mini Mind Slayer. So, yeah, I would just pick up one of each of these pets, park an alt down somewhere in the catacombs below Karazhan that has stealth, and then just check when it's past midnight server time and before 6 a.m. server time. All right, we are making our way through Northern Stranglethorn, and there's nothing terribly impressive in this zone. Now, one pet that I did snag the first time I was in here was Polly, because he can come in a power speed breed, and he's just a unique looking flying type pet. Like, there's not a lot that have that parrot character model, but other than that, everything else here is meh. So yeah, snag yourself a Polly while you're in here, and we'll head down to the southern part of Stranglethorn. Alright, we are down on the Cape of Stranglethorn, and we're flying to this little tiny island out here. And what's cool about this island is that it has the baby apes, okay? Now, that baby ape is a lot like the Silithid hatchling, in that it only spawns when certain weather effects are happening. Now, whenever it's raining, these little guys will spawn. And, you know, I would pick up a power breed and a balance breed. Recently, I saw a video from another pet battle guy named Hiru. I'll leave a link to his channel in the description. And anyway, he said this is one of the few pets that's actually worth picking up in a balance breed, just to get that little bit of extra speed so that you could really take advantage of Clobber. So anyway, he's also just a really cool pet. Like, he's the gorilla model. And there's not a lot of pets that have that same model. I think there's maybe two others. Let's see. Beryl Toss. Yeah, so we have the Dark Moon Monkey. Oh, and Bananas, who comes from the trading card game, who's really, really expensive. So we only have two pets in the game that have it. And mine is named Harambe, in memory of Harambe. Live on, my friend, live on. Also, small side note, there are some pets over in Booty Bay that you can buy, but after my last video and being torn apart by all the goblins in Winter Spring, I have learned my lesson to stay away from them. I did the Blood Sail Admiral title to get... I'm not sure if it was Blood Sail Admiral. I think that's what it is. Yeah, Blood Sail Admiral. I did that back at the end of Wrath of the Lich King, and I have never gone back to repair the reputation with all the goblins in the world, so they hate my warrior. Alright, we are over here in the Searing Gorge, and there's a cool looking rare here that I'm gonna get. And it dropped a cloak that I don't have. Anyway, that's the same character model as the Warlock starting mount. So, the pets I want to talk about in this area are these three here. Now, what's cool about the Lava Crab is that he is just a strong, solid elemental pet. You know, he's got a solid amount of health with 1627, and that's the health breed. The HH breed has 1800 health. With very low speed, but a decent attack. So yeah, I'd pick up an HH breed and an HS breed with this guy. He's got actually really strong heal with cauterize. So, I don't know. He's a really solid pet, and I like elementals. And so this is a aquatic-looking elemental-type pet who's very, very strong versus machines. Now, Conflagrate, that is a very hard-hitting ability, but he does not have any burns that are like a damage over time spell to make Conflagrate hit for the additional amount of damage. So that's one weakness this guy has, but he's just a cool pet. Now, what's cool about the Molten Hatchling and the Fire Beetle is that these are beast-type pets that have elemental movesets. And there's not a lot of those in the game, because once again, it's like a kind of double-sided coin where you have a beast-type pet that's strong versus mech-type pets. Excuse me, I was just like brain farting right there. And it's a little bit dangerous of a game to play where you're rolling a beast-type versus a machine just because mechanical damage destroys beasts. But that's what's cool about this area, is that all these pets have elemental-type moves. And this guy even has a dragon move. I'd pick up an health power breed instead of the HS breed, just because HS isn't that much faster than most things. So I would snag all three of those if you're in here getting some cool pets for your collection. All right, we're in our very last zone of the Eastern Kingdoms, and that is the Swamp of Sorrows. So in conclusion, Swamp of Sorrows, nothing special out here. And that wraps up the Eastern Kingdoms. If you found this video helpful, a like rating is always appreciated. Make sure to let me know in the comments if there's any pets that you think I left off the list, or, you know, if you have any questions about breeds that I might have forgotten to mention. If you have any questions at all or any kind of feedback, make sure to leave it in the comment section below and help me understand what you guys are looking to see. Anyway, it was a pleasure gaming with you this morning, guys, and I hope you have a fantastic day. You guys take care.